Hello, this is Sister Charlene Winston coming to you today with Saturday's Daily Bible Study, coming from Charlene's Outreach Ministries. I want to thank each of you for joining with me as we gather together to study and meditate on the Word of the Lord, that we become more proficient doers of His Word and not hearers only. Amen. Our lesson for today is Plea for Mercy. Plea for mercy. Amen. Our lesson is coming from Psalms 90, verse 13 through 17. Amen. This is a great and wonderful lesson as we move right on through our lesson. And as we, as you have already heard, Sunday's lesson, that it climaxes on Sunday's lesson, speaking of in the lesson concerning the judge that had the opportunity to get them freedom because they had been disobedient. Amen. And what it reminds us of and tells us that we can always get in God's good graces if we turn and repent. If we repent from what we are doing and stop and turn unto Him. Amen. We're going to get ready and get started, but first we're going to have prayer and then we're going to move right into the lesson. Dear God in heaven, we thank You. We thank You for all the blessings that You bestow upon us, those seen and unseen. We thank You for making a way out of no way. We thank You for leading us and guiding us in Your true path of righteousness. We thank You for all that You have done, You is doing, and You shall do in our lives. We thank You for making a way out of no way. Lord, lead us and guide us in Your true path of righteousness. Watch over us and strengthen us in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask that You guide our thoughts and our action as we go forth in our day. Heavenly Father, each one in the name of Jesus, as we rise in the morning, giving great gratitude and praise to You for bringing us through another day, and that You lead us in the day that is coming. We thank You, Lord Jesus, for all that You do in each of our lives. Lord, as we get ready, we want to thank You, Heavenly Father, for opening our eyes that we do see and our ears that we do hear. And we gain wisdom, knowledge, and understanding from on high to study, meditate, and learn of Your Word, that we will be more proficient in doing Your Word and not just hearers only. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, we're going to get ready and get started. But first, I want to ask if anything you see it touches your heart, soul, or spirit, or you have any questions or comments, please feel free to jot them at the bottom below. And I do appreciate each one of your comments and questions that you do bring forth. And I would like to ask you also, if you would, subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell to be notified each time we put out a new lesson. Amen. And I wanted to finish with saying that I will comment on your questions or statements that is brought forth, and I do appreciate it. Amen. We're going to get ready and get started with our lesson, Plea for Mercy, coming from Psalms 90, verses 13 through 17. And the scripture lesson text read, "Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on Your servants. Satisfy us in the morning with Your steadfast love, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad for as many days as You have afflicted us, and for as many years as we have seen evil. Let Your work be shown to Your servants, and Your glorious power to their children. Let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish the work of our hands upon us." Yes, establish the work of our hands. Amen. This is such a powerful and wonderful lesson, amen, that we have here teaching us and letting us know that we are to seek mercy from God, that He is a merciful God if we turn and come to Him. Amen. It says those who would learn true wisdom must pray for divine instruction, must beg to be taught by the Holy Spirit, and for comfort and joy in the returns of God's favor. They pray for the mercy of God, for they pretend not to plead any merit of their own. His favor would be a full fountain of future joys. It would be a sufficient balance to former griefs. Let the grace of God in us produce the light of good works, and let the divine consolation put gladness into our hearts and a luster upon our countenance. The work of our hand establish thou it, and in orders to that establish us in it. Instead of wasting our precious fleeting days in pursuing fancies which leave the possessors forever poor, let us see the forgiveness of sins and an inheritance in heaven. Let us pray that the work of the Holy Spirit may appear in converting our hearts, and that the beauty of holiness may be seen in our conduct. Amen. We want our conduct to show who we belong to, that we are a child of God. Amen. We want how we act and we behave in a manner that states and shows that we belong to God. Amen. This is such a wonderful and powerful lesson. I pray you meditate on this lesson. Have a blessed and wonderful day.